We will learn about the three states of matter. So what is matter? Matter is everything that we can see, touch, or feel. Based on kinetic theory of matter, we can say that matter can be divided into three states, that is solid, liquid, and gas. Kinetic theory of matter says that all matter is made up of tiny particles. And these particles have intermolecular force of attraction between them. So these particles are held together by intermolecular force of attraction. These particles are tightly packed for solid because the intermolecular force of attraction are very strong. Whereas for liquid, the particles are loosely packed because the intermolecular force are weak. Whereas for gases, the particles are very far away from each other. And this is because the intermolecular force are very, very weak. Kinetic theory of matter also says that all the particles in every matter are always in motion. They are in constant motion. But since solid are tightly packed, they have no motion, and therefore they have no kinetic energy. The particles in liquids are loosely packed, therefore they have little motion and little kinetic energy. But the particle in gas are very far away from each other. They have the maximum motion. They move randomly very fast everywhere. Therefore, they have maximum kinetic energy. So gases have maximum energy, solid have least energy, and liquids have moderate amount of kinetic energy. So this is all we can say about the three states of matter. Thank you, everyone.
The first point that this kinetic theory states, and it states that molecules are always in continuous state of motion. That is, if we have certain matter and these are the molecules of it, then these molecules are always in a state of motion. That is, they are always moving. And because of this eternal continuous movement of the motion, these molecules possess kinetic energy. So, the first property or the first point that of kinetic theory of matter states that all the molecules or atoms in a matter are always in the state of continuous motion and possess kinetic energy. Then the second point states that the kinetic energy of the molecules always increases with increase in temperature. That is, if we increase the temperature, the kinetic energy of these molecules will increase and they will start to move even faster than their previous motion. And this kinetic energy is decreasing with decrease in temperature. That is, when we cool the substance or the matter, then the molecules also slows down and its kinetic energy reduces. Then there is always a force of attraction between these molecules. We have these molecules and there is always a force of attraction between these, and if the force of attraction is between the similar kind of molecules, it is known as force of cohesion. And if these molecules are of different elements, then the force of attraction between these two is known as force of adhesion. Then the next property or the next point of kinetic energy states that these molecules have certain amount of space between them. Say we have a container and we have a liquid in this, and its molecules are like this. And you can observe that there is certain space between these molecules, and this space is known as intermolecular space. Then the next point is the intermolecular forces of attraction. That is the third point which we have already discussed, is the attractive forces between similar kind of molecules and different kind of molecules as cohesion and adhesion, and these forces of attraction are known as intermolecular forces of attraction. And why are they called intermolecular forces of attraction? Because they are between different molecules, so they are intermolecular forces of attraction. And the last point of this kinetics theory states that what is the relationship between the intermolecular forces of attraction and the spaces. So let us observe, say you have a liquid in a container and you have these molecules, and there is certain amount of interaction or attraction between these molecules, but they still have this intermolecular space. And say if we increase the pressure over the molecules of any substance and they come little closer, then in this case the intermolecular space is decreased, and the intermolecular force of attraction has increased because they are now closer. So they are inversely related. That is, if intermolecular force of attraction is reduced, that is if the molecules are far apart, then the intermolecular space has increased. And the other way of thinking it is that if this space is decreased, like in this case, then the intermolecular force of attraction has increased. So in the kinetic theory we have studied first that is molecules are in the state of continuous motion, and because of which they possess kinetic energy. The second step or the point is that kinetic energy increases with temperature and decreases with decrease in temperature. Then we always have a force of attraction between the atoms and molecules, and if the atoms or molecules are of similar kind, they are called as forces of cohesion, and if the atoms or molecules are of different types, then it is known as force of adhesion. Then we have always have certain intermolecular spaces between the molecules of matter. Fifth point is intermolecular forces of attraction are the attractive forces between similar or different kind of the atoms or molecules. And the last point states that the intermolecular force of attraction, if it is increased, the space decreases, or if the intermolecular forces of attraction increases, the space will decrease. So this was all about the kinetic theory of matter. And in the next session, we are going to discuss the arrangement of molecules or atoms in different states of matter.